So how many times have we heard what matters is the paddle, not the top? I'm going to tell you a personal story to show you that in my experience, this is true. 14 years I have been out with a group of people to climb the mountains, especially one 3,000 mountain in the Pyrenees in Spain. Last year, a friend who is a special friend of the club, who is every year preparing the whole adventure. He is preparing the accommodation, the mountain we are going to climb, the food, the cars, everything. He sent us an email telling us that last year it was going to be a very special trip. We are going to climb the Aneto, the highest mountain in the Peninsula Iberica, not in Spain, right? And on Monday, when we came back from the trip, we all received an email from him saying this: every time you experience a very special event, you should write it down. In such a way, every time you read it, you will be able to experience the same feelings you did the time you did it. So I'm going to tell you what his email told us. And basically, it is a tale and a story to climb the Aneto. So just in case you want to go one day. So this is a path. We woke up at 4 in the morning in Menasque, which is the closest, this is the closest town to the Aneto, to get the bus. The first bus starts at 5. You start here, you get the bus in Menasque to go to the Besulta refugee. Right. Besulta refugee. In here, in Besulta refugee, we started at 5:15 and start walking to go to Reclusa refugee. As you can see, at the beginning of the night, 5:15, there is no light. So we are enjoying the silence, we are enjoying the environment, and we are talking and really enjoying the path. Once we get to Besulta refugee, we got some more people there. It's about 45 minutes to arrive to Reclusa refugee. We got some people there who had to spend their nights to go on with the adventures. And now the adventure implies to go to the Portillon Superior. It's about 2 hours walking from the refugee to the Portillon Superior. As you can see, it is full of rocks. They are really sharp, so you have to be very careful. But at the same time, you are enjoying the downing, you are enjoying the conversation, and it is really nice to go through the nature and to go through the adventure. So at 8 in the morning, we got the Portillon Superior. And then you are there and you say, this is worth it. Just to be here, it is worth it. I don't want to go to the Aneto. This is worth enough with my friends and the nature. So at 8 in the morning, we are there with the beauty and the purity. And now we start, in his email, he told us, we start the second step of the climb. And for that second step, we have to take the ice axes, the crampons, and the cords, because we are going into the glacier of the Aneto. So this is the first challenge. The first challenge is the snowfield. It is a very short way, but it is very dangerous. So you have to be very careful and to be very concentrated. It is really short part, but very, very dangerous. Then you go into the second challenge. The farther you go, the more difficult and the more dangerous it is. So the second challenge is the perpetual snow. This ice is always there. No matter winter, autumn, spring, or summer, this ice is always there. So you have to be very careful. You have to go with your crampons because it is really dangerous. Have to be temperance and self-restraint to go through. And we go to the third challenge, which is to crossing the glacier. This is as well quite dangerous, but really nice, as you can see in the photographs. It is really worth it. And then, after we have enjoyed the path, we get to the top, almost to the top. Here we have the Mahoma Pass. You probably know it's 150 meters. Have to go and back just to see the course. So you can say, I have been at the very top once you get into the Aneto. However, if you want to pass through, you can do it as well. So you get the top of this path at 11. So you have been walking for 6 hours, and there. Now the way back. The way back, the path back, it goes by our youths at 3, the admiration and kindness of the nature, as you can see. And then again, you come back to the Besulta refugee, now daylight, at 5. You get the bus at 5, 12 hours after you took the first bus. And then the reward, you come back to Benasque at 6. Have some drinks, enjoy yourself, and so forth. So, after this, in his email, he told us, meanwhile you are reading this email, I'm suffering an operation from a very serious cancer. So, hopefully, he said, and here it is an important part, he said, hopefully this time I will be able to enjoy the path, because I'm not sure I will get the top. And as you can see, during his tape, he was giving us these words in red. And they are really the 7 heavenly virtues that hopefully will help him to get the very top.